Want to do some email?
Well, I guess you'll tell me what they are, then I'll let you know what I want to do. All right, go.
Okay, let's hope he doesn't say no.
Okay.
We're going to bring it on. This first one is from David, who says, "Hello, Pat and all the team. Since I was a boy, I have enjoyed the music of an artist who converted to Islam. As a Christian, is it okay to buy his new CD, given the fact that he's a very high-profile Muslim who's in a financial position to support their causes?"
You know, Bible says whatever is not of faith is sin, and the question is, what do you believe about it? You know, buying a Muslim CD is no big deal. The question is, what do you feel? If you feel it's wrong, then don't do it. It's that simple. Whatever is not of faith is sin. Mm-hmm. So you ask me, and you'll have to answer that one yourself.
Right. This is Mark Pat, who says, "My daughter's been living with a man for 3 years and has a baby by him. She's told her kids that they're married, but she won't marry him because she's had two husbands already. She told me once that it's easier to get forgiveness than permission. I tell her that forgiveness is for when you fall into sin and not for premeditated sin. Who is right?"
You're absolutely right on that one. This girl's playing games. I don't know what kind of bringing up she had, but she didn't have a very good one, it doesn't sound like. A couple of marriages already. I mean, she's obviously undisciplined, rebellious. She can't hold a stable relationship, and now she won't enter into one even though she's got a child by this man. And then she's tempting God. I mean, man, she is walking on the edge. You think, well, Linda was taking a chance. I mean, she's really on a tightrope. And she is, I mean, I would certainly pray for her and I'd warn her because she's asking for it. And it's going to be really tough. But don't tell me it's easier to ask for forgiveness and permission. I mean, that's a big joke. Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm. But not when you're dealing with the Lord. I mean, sooner or later, God's going to say, that's all she wrote, baby, and it's going to be tough. All right.
This is a viewer who says, "Why do people fall out when the Holy Spirit is heavier when it hits them?"
Well, you remember when they came to arrest Jesus, and they said, "We've come for Jesus," and he said, "I'm the one," and they fell back. When you're in the presence of the power of God, whether it's an angel or whether it's the overwhelming power of God, the flesh that we have just isn't strong enough to stand up against that situation. Now, some of this falling out is fake, some of it is contrived and all this other, but when the real power of God is there, the person can't stand, is what it amounts to. And we have cases, for example, Daniel, who's in front of an angel, an angelic being, and his strength left him, he just collapsed. Because it's so overwhelming, the other power that is inherent in one of these angelic beings, or certainly in the Holy Spirit himself.
Okay, Pat, this is Christy, who says, "Our adult prodigal daughter is living with her abusive boyfriend and is now pregnant. We have not supported her lifestyle and have taken a stand against the boyfriend, who is verbally and physically abusive to her. We tried to do Bible studies at first with him to lead him to the Lord and spend time with him, but when he posted a naked picture of her on Facebook and started giving her drugs and alcohol, we severed contact with him only. We have kept in communication and relationship with her, but then he told her she couldn't come around us anymore. She's recently told us if we won't accept him, then we'll never see her or her baby. We offered to help if she leaves him, but all she says is we have to accept him or we won't have a relationship. What do we do now?"
You're going to have to say goodbye to that daughter. It'll break your heart. You have to pray for her and just say, "Look, I love you. And if the time comes you want to straighten out, we'll always be here for you. But until then, we're not going to buy into this lifestyle and don't think we are." You know, if you that's your choice, you've made your bed, you're going to lie in it, and don't ask us for help. But we'll certainly pray for you. And I think that's the way, but you don't want to be an enabler. You don't want to get involved in this. But my goodness, what kind of girl is she? And why does she want to be hurt? It's so hard to understand these women that have an abusive relationship, a man who beats them up, and yet they keep going back to them. Somehow they feel like they deserve it, and they get this psychopath. She ought to leave this guy right now. She ought to bring charges against him. I mean, he's doing some pretty terrible stuff. including passing out, I guess, I don't know if you consider a naked picture of your girlfriend as porn or not, but I dare say he's broken some laws doing what he did on that. I don't know all the circumstances. But all I can say is, in your case, cry out to God for that daughter and don't stop praying for her. Let her know you're praying for her, but let her know you're not going to buy into any of this, and she's got to come out of it, and she's got to make her own decision. She's old enough, big enough, she's an adult, and she's been captured, and you need to pray that she'll be delivered, but she's got to say yes. She's got to, like the prodigal son, the Bible says he came to himself. She's got to come to herself and say, I've got to go back to my father's house, but she hadn't done that yet. Don't be an enabler. Don't help her. Don't give her money and all that. All the poor child, give her money. No, don't do that. Mm-hmm. Leave her. Pray for her. All right.
Yeah, sometimes out of their mistakes comes wisdom.
You
hopefully.
Pray, Terry, otherwise that girl's going to wind up dead. You know, exactly. It just breaks your heart, but that's the, I mean, for a parent, it breaks your heart.
It does break your heart.
Yeah.
Well, that's all the time we have for your email today, but we want to say thank you. We really enjoy hearing from you when you submit your questions.